Welcome back to the channel where we help you make the transition to Google Analytics 4. And today we're going to talk about one of the tools that I use on a daily basis to make sure conversions are tracking and that everything is set up right in Google Tag Manager to get your website statistics, and that is Google Tag Assistant. You may have heard of this before, but Google Tag Assistant does help you monitor and make sure that your conversions are working. It helps you make sure that your containers are firing and all your tags and triggers are working correctly, so that way you get the correct data in Google Analytics. Let's start off with tag analysis. Of course, this is one of the things that you can do with Google Tag Assistant. And if you see here, you have the different colors of tags. And then for this website, if you install Google Tag Assistant, you can actually go to websites and see which people have Google Tag Manager installed. And in this example, this is the Google Tag Assistant, and it helps me show if the containers are installed properly on the website. Now, after you get to your tag analysis, you want to go to your Google Chrome store and install the Google Tag Assistant. And we're going to show you how to do that step by step in just a moment. But the Google Chrome extension does allow you to put in the Google Tag Assistant and install it very quickly. And then that way you can monitor your website analysis. So it's in the Google Chrome store, and you want to search for Tag Assistant, and it's the Tag Assistant by Google. It's normally the featured one. And then there are some other ones for some other Google Tag Assistant's help, but the main one is the Tag Assistant by Google. It's the top one here, and it's just type in Tag Assistant for it to come up in the Google Chrome store. Now, what you want to do once you get that is select it, and then you want to add it to Chrome. So that way, every time you bring up Chrome as your browser, you'll be able to use the Google Tag Assistant. And even if you use Firefox and some of the other things as your main browser, you can still have an account for using for Google Tag Assistant and some of the other tag assistants that are able, you can enter on the Chrome store, download them and use them for some of the other things as well. So it's the Tag Assistant Legacy by Google, add it to Chrome. And we're going to show you how to do that in this video. Inside the Google Chrome store, you'll search for Google Tag Assistant or just Tag Assistants. And when you type that in, Google Tag Assistant will come up. You will want to select the Tag Assistant Legacy, and then you'll want to add that to Chrome. So by doing this, will install the Tag Assistant. When you click on the Add to Chrome, it'll say Add Extension, and that is where you will add the extension to Google Chrome. If you want to sync it across all of your devices, you can do that option. If you just want it on the one local computer, do not hit the sync button. So that is Google Tag Assistant, how to install it, very simple process. The main thing you want to do with Google Tag Assistant is to make sure that your containers are working, make sure that the tags are firing, and most importantly, make sure that your conversions are tracking. You're going to want to do that in Google Tag Manager in your preview, but you can also see that your tag containers are working correctly. So Google Tag Assistant is one of those things that I use on a daily basis. This is probably one of the first things you want to do if you're just adding a website, getting a website up and running, making sure that your e-commerce store, if you've got a blog, if you've got a lead type generation system, because you're going to want to install GA4, and you're going to want to make sure that all your tags are working and firing to make sure that you're getting the best use for your correct data in GA4. Hopefully that helps installing the Google Tag Assistant.